This is top Orlando Realtor Scott Garrison with ReMax Town and Country Real Estate. This is part two of a two-part series on how to pick the best realtor for you. Oftentimes I have clients who get a little confused trying to pick Realtor A, Realtor B. How do you really know? Unlike doctors and accountants and everything like that where it's hard to find who is the best and who's not, it's pretty easy if you're a realtor. So see my first video where I talk about the Zillow, YouTube, Google Challenge, which is the best way to differentiate a couple of different agents. This is about how to pick agents now on a personal basis. If you're not sure, like, should I get a big team? Should I get a not big team? So the first thing is you don't want a new agent. You don't want a part-time agent. You can tell because they won't have an online presence. New agents just don't have the time and energy and effort to get the reviews that they need, for instance, when you look on Zillow.com. So make sure that they're full-time, make sure they're with a big company. Next thing is I definitely don't ever recommend that you work in either buying or selling with a discount agent. For instance, if you're going to sell a house and the normal commission is X percent, a discount agent will come to you and say, well, I'm not going to do very much, but I'm not going to charge very much. And that small little percent that you think you're going to save is going to go very, very fast when your home doesn't get marketed as well, doesn't get as exposed as well, you end up taking a lower offer. So a good normal agent with a good normal brokerage fee is what's going to get you the most money for your home. And you never, ever save money with a discount agent. So now you've got a bunch of normal agents that are full-time. And you say, well, how do we pick? Do you get a big company? Do you not? I recommend that you get a good medium-sized agent. If you get a big agent, one of these agents, there are a couple agents in town, for instance, who everything goes out in their name, but they actually have 18 or 20 agents underneath them. But those agents are, just like you would do if you were hiring a real estate company, and if you were getting started, you would hire a bunch of agents that don't want to earn very much money, that you don't have to pay very much, new agents, and then they would use your name to go out there. So just like if you had a business, it's very, very normal that you hire someone, and the person who the public interacts with in a business often is the lowest paid, lowest skilled person in the business. That's not the kind of person you don't want to go with. You don't want to go with a big mega team that says we've sold 700 homes in the last 2 years, because that agent personally has probably sold only a small fraction of that, and you're going to end up working with a non-licensed assistant or a new agent who are the agents that want to be part of that system because they don't have a business on their own. So now that leaves us a good medium-sized agent, it's very, very important that you get an agent who you're not going to end up working with their assistant. Even on medium-sized agents, a lot of times will have an assistant or someone in their family or something like that that is not as skilled or is not as experienced in the business. So you want, here's the test. You call the agent, they should call you back personally. Just like your accountant. Wouldn't it be great if you called your accountant, picked up the phone, and he called you back? Wouldn't it be great if you had a doctor or a vet you could just call and they call you back? Well, with real estate, you're going to pay the same anyway. You might as well get a good agent, or if it's you're buying a house, it's free. Get a good agent who you call, goes to his voicemail or her voicemail, and then they call you back. That personal one-on-one service is what you're paying for. And that's the best way, other than the Zillow, YouTube, Realtor.com challenge, to actually pick a realtor.